Let's say that our law professor, Professor Miao, gives me $5 out of the kindness of her heart and tells me to use it to buy ice cream for you. Something very interesting happens here. I hold the $5, but it is not really mine. It's yours. In very broad terms, anytime someone holds stuff for the benefit of others, the law might say that a trust has been created. Now, before we explore further, let's talk about some legal terms. Using the $5 to buy ice cream example, there are three actors involved in this trust. First, Professor Miao creates the trust, and without her, there would be no money and no ice cream for anyone. It could be said that she settles the arrangement between you and I, so the law calls her the settler. Next, Professor Miao, the settler, gave her instructions to me, and I'm supposed to use her money in the way she wants me to use it. Because I received the instructions of the trust, the law calls me the trustee. Finally, you come in. Your only job here is to receive the benefits of the trust. So the law calls you the beneficiary. Those are the three parties to the trust: settler, trustee, and beneficiary. Got it? That's great. Now let's explore the trust idea a little bit. Let's say I take Professor Miao's $5 and I faithfully use it to buy the ice cream for you. But on the way to your place, the ice cream disappears because I accidentally ate it. In this situation, as much as Professor Miao might be disappointed in me, it is you who would be most unhappy about what I did. So you could ask me to buy another ice cream for you using my own money. Now, two things happened here. First, I went against the instructions given by Professor Miao. The law calls this, simply enough, a breach of trust. Along with that, you wanted me to make amends for my breach of trust by giving you what you should have gotten. The law calls this a remedy for breach of trust. With these ideas in mind, that is, of breaches of trust and remedies for breaches, let's play with more examples. Let's say I don't buy the ice cream, but I give my money to my friend, and he buys the ice cream using the $5 from Professor Miao. I've clearly breached this trust, and the law might let you take the ice cream from my friend, because he clearly bought it using Professor Miao's money. We call this the proprietary claim for breach of trust. Or let's say that I use the $5 to buy chocolate instead of ice cream. Or I definitely breached the trust, because Professor Miao told me to buy ice cream and not chocolate. You could choose between demanding an ice cream from me or just taking the chocolate. That's the idea of election. Finally, let's say that I buy the ice cream, but then you tell me, hey, you can eat the ice cream instead. I ask in reply, are you sure? And you say, yeah, I mean it, just eat it. If I then decide to eat the ice cream, you cannot say I breached the trust, because you gave your informed consent. So that's all we'll be talking about today. In today's video, we gave names to the three parties of the trust: the settler, trustee, and beneficiary. We also explored some fun examples regarding breaches of trust. Now, trust law is just incredibly fascinating, and personally, it's my favorite private law subject. But for the law students watching this, it's also an incredibly technical subject, so don't forget to do your readings as well. In any case, hope you enjoyed this video and that it was useful for your understanding. Take care, everyone, and much cheers to all of you.